Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about Boolean operations. The Boolean data type is named after George Bool, an English mathematician. Python Boolean expressions are commonly used as conditions in the if and while statements. A Boolean expression can only return one of two values, true or false. Simple Boolean expressions compare two values using these operators. The first four operators are very easy to understand. Notice the use of double equals for equality check. A common mistake is using a single equal when you should use double equals in conditions. Python uses single equal to indicate assignment. Exclamation equal means not equal in Python. The keyword is used to check if one object is another. Is not is used to check if one object is not another. These comparison operators can be applied to data types like numbers and strings. They all have the same priority. Comparisons can be chained. For example, x less than y less than or equal to z is equivalent to x less than y and y less than or equal to z. This is a very simple example. Is 3 less than 4? The answer is true. Is 4 times 3 less than 4 plus 3? This is equivalent to this comparison with parentheses. That means, is 12 less than 7? The answer is false. These are number comparisons. String comparisons are based on the order of the underlying ASCII and Unicode. I already talked about the ASCII code in another video in this course. It's titled String Encoding and Formatting. Here is an example. Is hello equal to hello? They are exactly the same, so the answer is true. Is hello less than this hello with a capital letter H? Because lowercase letters come after uppercase letters in the ASCII table, the answer to this question is false. When we do the comparison, we should always compare strings with strings and numbers with numbers. If we compare hello, which is a string, with 256, which is a number, we will see an error. If we apply the type function on the keyword true or false, we will see they are Boolean. These two words are case sensitive. If we change them to lowercase words like these, we will see an error. Now I'll talk about how to assemble multiple simple Boolean expressions together to make a complex Boolean expression using the AND or NOT operators. The AND operation of two Boolean variables, x and y, is true only if both x and y are true. It resembles a multiplication operation. Here is the truth table. Think of a true as 1 and false as 0. 1 times 1 equals 1. 1 times 0 equals 0. 0 times 1 equals 0. 0 times 0 equals 0. The OR operation of two Boolean variables x and y is true when either x or y is true. It resembles the addition operation. Still think of true as 1 and false as 0. Any value that is larger than 1 will be kept at 1. 1 plus 1 equals 2, which will be kept at 1. 1 plus 0 equals 1. 0 plus 1 equals 1. 0 plus 0 equals 0. NOT is a negation operator. It will change a Boolean variable x to its opposite. NOT true means false. NOT false means true. Let's see some examples. X equals true. Update x to be not x. So now x will be false. In this statement, is 3 less than or equal to 5? The answer to this part is true. So y equals true. X is false, y is true. So x and y is false. In this statement, we will check if this part is true. It means, is a space not equal to an empty string? This is true. they are not the same. So z equals true, x is false, z is true, so x or z is true. The interpretation of the complex Boolean expressions rely on the precedence rules for the operators. The order of precedence from high to low is not, and, or. These operators have lower priorities than the simple comparison operators I mentioned earlier. For complex expressions, it is recommended to use parentheses to prevent confusion. Here is an example. We use simultaneous assignment to assign false, true, true to x, y, and z respectively. After that, let's check this expression. It is equivalent to this expression with parentheses. Because not has the highest precedence and y is true, not y is false. Next, we proceed with the AND operation. Because x is false, so false and false is still false. Finally, let's check false or z. Because z is true, so false or true is true. The entire expression is true. Sometimes the following Boolean algebra laws can be used to simplify Boolean expressions. The first one is the double negation law. Double not will cancel out, so not not x is just x. The second one is a commutative law. X and y is equivalent to y and x. X or y is equivalent to y or x. The third one is the associative law. You have two AND operations on three or more variables. It doesn't matter which two variables we choose to operate on first. The same rule applies when we have two OR operations on three or more variables. The fourth one is the distributive law. This law specifies how x can be distributed in these two cases. The last one is De Morgan's law. It specifies how not can be distributed in these two cases. I list these laws here so you can use this table as a reference. Here is an example. In a dice game, a player wins if he rolls double sixes with two dice. That means he wins if D1 is equal to 6 and D2 is equal to 6. He loses with other number combinations. That means not this condition. Using the De Morgan's law, we can rewrite the losing condition as not D1 equals 6 or not D2 equals 6. This is equivalent to D1 is not equal to 6 or D2 is not equal to 6. We can use a Python function bool to convert other built-in data type to a Boolean. Python will use the following two general rules to do this. For integer or float number, the value 0 will be converted to a false, and a non-zero value will be converted to a true. For a string, list, tuple, dictionary, or set, it will be converted to a false if it's empty, and a true if not empty. Let's see some examples. The number 0 will be converted to false. The number 1 will be converted to true. Negative 2.1 is not 0, so it will be converted to true. A string hello is not empty, so it will be converted to true. This is an empty string, so it will be converted to false. This list is not empty, so it will be converted to true. This is an empty tuple, so it will be converted to false. This set is not empty, so it will be converted to true. Python AND, OR, NOT are short-circuit operators. A true or false will be returned as soon as the result can be determined. That means, if the result can be determined based on only a part of the expression, the rest of the expression will not even be evaluated. This table shows what the short-circuit operation means. Consider x and y. In order for this to be true, both x and y must be true. As soon as x is found to be false, we know the entire expression is false. We don't even need to finish evaluating the rest of the expression. If x is true, we just return y's value, no matter whether it's true or false. Similarly, let's consider x or y. As long as one of them is true, the entire expression is true, and we don't need to finish evaluating the rest of the expression. If x is false, we just return y's value, no matter whether it's true or false. For this not x, if x is false, then it returns true, else it returns false. Let's see some applications of these short-circuit rules. 3 and negative 1 are simultaneously assigned to x and y, respectively. This expression is equivalent to this version with parentheses. X is 3. 3 is not greater than or equal to 5, so this part is false. Based on the short-circuit rule, we just return y's value, which is negative 1. The second example. Let's consider another dice game. A player wins if she rolls a 5 or 6 with a single die. Can we write the winning condition like this? D1 equals 5 or 6. The answer is no. This is because it's equivalent to D1 equals 5 or 6. 6 is a non-zero number, therefore the expression will always be true, no matter how many points are rolled. The correct winning condition is D1 equals 5 or D1 equals 6, which is equivalent to this version with parentheses. The last example. Imagine that you are in a coffee shop and the clerk asks you what type of coffee you would like to drink. Cappuccino, latte, or mocha. Let's implement it in Python. We define the main function. We prompt the user with the message, what type of coffee would you like? Latte is the default answer. We wait for the user to type in the answer. Then we print, you ordered a answer or latte. If the answer is empty, that means the user directly hits enter. Based on the short circuit rule, the OR operation will just return latte. If the user type in some name like mocha, then answer is not empty, and the entire expression will just return the answer, and it will ignore latte. The last line is a function call. What type of coffee would you like? I directly hit enter and choose latte. The output shows you ordered a latte. Call this function again, this time my input is mocha. The output is you ordered a mocha. Okay, that was a brief introduction to Boolean operations. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.